Hi friends, still at home, right? We wish all of us always to be happy and healthy. At home doesn't mean you stop being productive. Let's study. This time, we will share about ethnomathematics in Asia. Our source is from the Review of Educational Research Journal with the title Chinese Number Words, Culture, and Mathematics Learning by Sharon Sui Ngan from the Hong Kong Institute of Education and Nirmala Rao from the University of Hong Kong. Previously, introduced us from Group 5, this is Diaz, this is Wafiq, and this is Alfa. We are students from Mathematics Department, Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Sciences, Universitas Negeri Semarang. First, there is abstract. This review evaluates the role of language, specifically the Chinese-based system of number words and the simplicity of Chinese mathematical term, in explaining the relatively superior performance of Chinese and other East Asian students in cross-national studies of mathematics achievement. Relevant research is critically reviewed, focusing on linguistic and cultural influences. The review provides equivocal findings about the extent to which number words in the Chinese language afford benefits for mathematical learning, and indicates that culture and contextual factors are gaining prominence in accounting for the superior performance of East Asian students in cross-national studies, and yields emerging evidence from neuroscience that highlight interrelationship among language, cultural beliefs, and mathematical learning. Although it is not possible to disentangle the influence of linguistic, cultural, and contextual factors on mathematics performance, language is still seen as contributing to early cross-national differences in mathematics attainment. Background. How important is the system of number words and the transparency of mathematical terms in a language in counting for cross-national differences in achievement? For example, the Chinese-based number word system reflects its underlying base 10 structure more clearly than does the English number naming system. Also, the mathematical term used in Chinese are relatively simple in comparison with those in Western language. This stated by Han and Ginsberg in 2001. Against this background, this review considers the extent to which the Chinese-based system of number words and mathematics language accounts for the relatively superior performance of Chinese and other East Asian students in cross-national studies of mathematics. Overview. This review discusses the extent to which language influences mathematics learning. After discussing language, the present review considers the role of culture in mathematical learning. This review also examines the relative importance of language and culture in influencing mathematics learning. And in the final section of empirical work, the review discusses brain imaging studies that consider arithmetic processing. The review methods. This study involved participants from ethnic Chinese, both living in Chinese and foreign communities. In addition, relevant studies are also conducted in East Asian Confucian heritage societies such as Korea and Japan, were considered suitably representative for this in-depth investigation into the potential influences of language and culture on mathematics learning. The first step taken is searching electronic database to identify peer-reviewed journal articles, scholarly books, and chapters in edited books published from 1982 to 2009. In total, there are 108 publications that were included in the analysis. 80 journal articles, 3 in Chinese, 8 author books, and 20 chapters from edited books. Furthermore, the authors conduct a review of the entire literature that has been obtained. Next is the nature, timing, and limits of the influence of mathematical language on mathematics learning. For the first, nature, the Chinese number system. Some differences between number system in Arabic, English, and Chinese language. First, the base 10 system of Arabic numerals has a standard visual format but differs in sound across language. Second, the English number system is non-systematic, has several exceptions, is relatively poorly designed for counting, and is perceived to be harder to learn than Chinese. And the last is Chinese number words are described as being clear, transparent, straightforward, and conceptually well designed, as well as a logical representation of the base 10 system. For the example of using Chinese language in relation to mathematics, there are two examples. First, in the family, the relatives are known by their order in the family. For example, the eldest brother is referred to as brother number one, and then for the second is brother number two, brother number three, and so on. And the second example is in the names of the days of the week and months are referred to by number. For example is weekday number one, weekday number two, month number one, month number two, and so on. So, what do you think about this? Of course, this allows children to acquire and practice numerical concepts in daily life without special instructions. Next. In Chinese, the number names from 1 to 9 are single-syllable words, which is not the case for all languages. So, what is single-syllable words? In Bahasa, single-syllable word is satu kata, satu suku kata maksudnya. Nah, for example, if we say in English 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that are in single syllable words. But when we say 7, there are two syllable words. And 8, 9, 10 are single syllable words. So, what do you think about that? Yep, the short one-syllable words for Chinese numerals obviously limit the burden of on working memory when someone is learning a new thing. There are several ways in which the Chinese-based number system is beneficial for early mathematics learning. First, Chinese number words above 10 are generated by consistent rules. This is different with the English number names above 10 that have a few irregular modifications. The spoken Chinese number names from 11 to 19 systematically follow the base 10 rule and differ from the names of other two-digit numbers only in applying a one deletion rule. For example, the literal translation of 11 from Chinese into English is 101, where the value of the tens unit 1 in the two digits is usually not a name. Based on this rule, 12 is read as 102, and 13 as 103. The meaning is also transparent as 1, 10, and some ones, such as 11 equals 10 and 1, 12 equals 10 and 2. Nah, this rule is important for classroom teaching because certain instructional methods are useful only with number system wherein the 10 number names are spoken in the form of 10-1, 10-2, and so on. This state by Murata and Fuson in 20 and 06. Second, the consistent rule for generating Chinese number from 20 to 19 gives Chinese-speaking mathematics learners an advantage over their English-speaking counterparts in that decade names are formed simply by combining a unit value and the base 10. For example, the number 20 and 5 is literally translated as 2 and 5. Next, the Chinese generating numbers of 100 with unit values from 1 to 9, with the term for 100 in English being bei yi in Chinese, and followed by a two-digit number. Literally, for the example, a number 127 is read as 1 bei yi 2 10 7. Next, there is no marker for singular and plural in number names and the correspondence between spoken and written number names. This is make the Chinese number system more transparent for beginning learners. Next, there is a marked boundary between 10 and 11 in Chinese. It's a critical factor in early mathematics learning because it is the first clue that number names are organized according to a base 10 system. Next, the Chinese language has one inconsistency appearing in the first decade above 100, from 101 to 109, with the insertion of the word ling, representing 0 in front of the unit value to mark the empty 10th place. The next is place value. As noted earlier, the English and Chinese number system both use the same set of Hindu-Arabic numerals, which are organized around a strict base 10 system, but which differ in the rules used to name those numbers. In Chinese, 11 is read as 10-1, and 21 is read as 2-10-1, and these names clearly indicate that the 10-digit concept. In contrast, English has a lack of correspondence between number words and the base 10 system, which makes the learning of place value and single and multi-digit addition and subtraction more difficult for English-speaking children than for Chinese children. For example, the English word 13 doesn't have any clear link with its numeric representation 13, 1, 3. Don't have any clear link because the elements of tens and ones are not clearly named. Children can have difficulties understanding the place value, which can in turn cause them to overgeneralize by inventing number words such as 2010 and 2011 by Fuson in 1982 and 1988.
A number of studies have shown that characteristics of number system affect children's understanding of place value. Studies comparing preschool and our first graders in China, Korea, Japan, and the United States. In the United States and Japan, in France, Korea, Japan, Sweden and the United States, and in Hong Kong and the United States, have all found that ASEAN children show a better understanding of place value than to European and American children. Not that cross-cultural difference occur before the concept of place value is taught at follow. That ASEAN students prefer to use construction of tens and ones to show numbers, such as that face values were an integral component of their representation. In contrast, English-speaking children prefer to use a collection of units, which suggests that they were representing number as a grouping of counted objects. Furthermore, the use of canonical construction signals greater flexibility in approaching mental number manipulation. Next, Susan and Won examine Korean children who were solving addition problems at the end of the first semester of the first grade. Susan and Won studied Korean second and third grade children's understanding of multi-digit addition and subtraction, with a focus on their ability to explain the tracking required when a column of the addend had a sum of 10 or more. Murata found that Japanese language number names facilitate first grade children's learning of addition involving 10. Wu and Busan found that 4 and 5-year-old Hong Kong Chinese children perform better than English and American children in root counting, place value numeration, embed 10 cardinal understanding, and applying this knowledge to solve simple addition problems. Miller et al. Found that the influence of language on mathematics achievement was limited to the aspect of counting that involved number naming and the base 10 concepts. However, pointed out how Chinese mathematical terms that children to learn to connect mathematical ideas and to shape their thinking with respect to geometry and the part-whole relationship. Han and Ginsburg investigate who expert evaluated the clarity of a list of Chinese and English mathematics work and conclude that the Chinese language produced this clarity by using compound word to present clear account of basic ideas, some visual and some abstract. We also found that Chinese speaking and bilingual group aged 13 to 15 years score higher than did English speaking students on a special mathematics test targeted to rate the clarity of frequently used mathematical words. Kelly, Miller, Fang and Fang found that the dominant strategies that Chinese speakers acquire and use in early childhood were also executed in adulthood. They observed second grader, fourth grader, and adult in China and the United States solving calendar problems. As not previously, in Chinese, numerals are used to denote days of the week and months. Results indicate that at all ages, Chinese speakers solve the calendar problems at faster speed than did the English speakers in the corresponding age group. In conclusion, the studies review here show that language is an important factor to learning number structure, counting, and arithmetic operation. Children from countries using the Chinese-based system of number words perform at similar level in mathematics, and day 2 Peter then return to learn mathematics in English or other European language. Chinese based system of number words benefit students learning of basic number concept in a number of ways. First, Chinese children learn the number 11 to 19 relatively more quickly because of the clarity of Chinese number words and the lack of problems with 10 numbers. Second, Chinese and the other East Asian children learn to generalize patterns and rules to larger numbers comparatively faster because of the spoken base in numbers word in the East Asian number system. Third, teaching methods derive from the base 10 concept, such as the make 10 method used in Chinese textbook can help children visualize the spoken number word and understand number concept more clearly. Fourth, the consistent use of grouping of 10 in the number word support children in learning decomposition methods factor around 10 more efficiently. Finally, Chinese children may benefit from the simple method by which Chinese original numbers are formed. Chinese culture place and emphasis the learning of mathematical concept from the preschool years, and parents in major Chinese cities teach children basic arithmetical operation in the home context before school entry. The high value for to education by Chinese parents is reflected in their socialization practice, and they emphasize effort over ability in explaining their children's academic performance. Ethnic Chinese parents also have higher expectations for their children's mathematics achievement than to Euro-American ones, and this expectation may in turn lead to Chinese children spending more time and exerting more effort in mathematics learning. In conclusion, diverging views of learning between ASEAN and Western parents and students lead to varying cultural contexts for mathematics learning, and this context interact with culturally distinct number word system and mathematics language to account for the superior performance of Chinese students compared to Western students in cross-cultural difference in mathematics achievement.
The next is teachers' beliefs and classroom practices, the implemented curriculum. Teachers' beliefs and conceptions about mathematics have a significant influence on teachers' selection of mathematics content and their teaching strategies, and they are considered important mediators between the subject and the learner. This is according to Thompson 1984 and 1992. Research has found difference between Chinese and American elementary school mathematics teachers in their mathematical content, knowledge, and their beliefs about mathematics teaching and learning. This is according to Correa, Perry, Sims, Miller, and Feng in 2008. They found that Chinese teachers emphasized students' interest in mathematics and the application of mathematics in daily life situations. In contrast, American teachers stressed individual differences in learning styles and abilities and the importance of practice and repetition of mathematical problems These cultural differences regarding how students learn mathematics may further explain cross-national differences in mathematics teaching and learning, given that teachers believe presumably influence their instructional practices and thus student learning. Another example of how differences in cultural belief are reflected in classroom practice can be seen in the way in which American and Asian teachers differ in the type of manipulatives they use in mathematics teaching and the manner in which they use them. ASEAN students are well supported in terms of well-designed curricula and more coherent lesson organization. Note that no studies have focused on cross-cultural differences in mathematics curriculum and pedagogy during the preschool years, which makes it difficult to determine whether the number system or cultural support for learning or of basic number concept is more important in explaining early mathematics achievement. And for the next is cultural change in mathematics learning and performance. Cross-cultural differences in mathematics attainment between Chinese and American participants may be a function of cohort effects and other cultural influences. Geary et al. In 1996 compared the performance of younger and older American and Chinese participants in arithmetic, perceptual speed, and spatial orientation, and found no differences between American and Chinese adults on these measures. The younger Chinese participants performed better than the younger American adults in the arithmetic test, but not the perceptual speed or spatial orientation test. The authors concluded that the performance difference between East Asian and Americans might not have existed 60 years ago when the older participants were children, and that the current better performance of East Asian students in arithmetic may reflect secular change within the United States. Change in the focus of mathematics instruction have been identified in China and the United States. In China, teaching of elementary mathematics tends to be more interactive, and various teaching strategies have been introduced to promote children's thinking. This is according to Zhang and Zhou in 2003. Yet, the role of meaningful practices in learning counting, according to Zur and Gilman 2004, page 136, has been recognized in the United States. It appears that classroom instruction today is different from that reported in studies conducted more than 20 years ago. This is according to Stephenson et al. In 1986. The next one is revisiting the issue of digit span and working memory. Cultural factors need to be considered in relation to digit span and working memory. Stickler, Lee, and Stephenson in 1986 conducted three studies with native speakers of Chinese and English, comparing short-term memory for digits. The first study included preschool first graders and fifth graders in Taiwan, Japan, and the United States. The Chinese children were found to have longer digit spans than those of the Japanese and American children at all levels, but the patterns of result was not attributed to the Chinese-based system of number words, given that the same system is used in Japan. The second study, based on the previous observation, sampled 26-year-old and 27-year-olds in preschool and first grade in Taiwan and the United States. The children were asked to count forward and backward. The last is the final study examined the time required to pronounce number words in Chinese and English and whether this might account for the observed difference in digit memory. So, in summary, there are cultural differences in parents, students, and teachers' beliefs instructional practices, textbook presentation, and children's strategy use. We argue that Chinese parents' beliefs affect their socialization practices, that teachers' pedagogical beliefs affect their decisions in their classroom, and that adult behaviors are associated with children's learning outcomes. Hence, this cultural difference in beliefs contribute to cross-national differences in mathematical attainment via the practices of parents and teachers. Although we cannot determine the extent of cultural influences vis-a-vis the Chinese-based system of number words on mathematical attainment, cross-cultural differences in parents and teachers' belief and instructional practices are clearly pervasive, and the number word system has a considerable influence on early mathematics achievement. Hence, it is imperative to consider the cultural context in which a number word system is used to ascertain its role in mathematics learning and achievement. And the next part is the influence of language on mathematics learning, evidence from neuroscience. Assuming that cultural factor may affect number representation and arithmetic processing in the brain, according to Tang et al. In 2006 performed functional magnetic resonance imaging to compare arithmetic tasks induced change in brain activity between adult native speakers of English and Chinese as they performed four tasks: simple orientation, spatial orientation of number words, addition, and quantity comparison. The results suggest that whereas the numbers are represented in different brain regions from those involved in language, people speaking Chinese or English may engage different neural pathways in numerical processing. In page 10,676, and that performing arithmetic depends more on language processing than on the quantity comparison task. The researcher concluded that language differences cannot be the only explanation for the different biological encoding of number. Instead, differential brain processes may be shaped by visual reading experience during language acquisition and other cultural factors such as mathematic learning strategies and the education system. And in the conclusion, the results of this review suggest that the number system and the simplicity of mathematics language in Chinese-based system of number words offer advantages for early mathematics learning, but that cultural factors are also important. Because language and culture are so closely interrelated, it is difficult to disentangle the individual influences of linguistic and cultural factors on mathematics performance. And the second, however, this review indicates that the influence of language is not limited to the acquisition of number concept. It also appears to benefit Chinese children in learning other mathematics concept, an influence that extends beyond the early years. There is a dearth of empirical research in areas other than number acquisition and arithmetic operations, and few studies have been conducted with young children when schooling influences are less pronounced. Although the number word system and language of a cultural group are set factors, it is important to investigate and develop instructional methods based on cultural characteristics that help children to learn effectively. And the next, despite the fact that the Chinese-based number word system affords benefits for Chinese children in learning early number concepts naturally, this is not the complete picture. The diversity in cultural views between Chinese and Westerners concerning the importance of mathematics achievement and the ways of bringing it about has been well documented. And the last, as noted earlier, it is difficult to determine the precise influence of cultural and contextual factor on mathematics learning. It is also difficult to change them. The Chinese-based system of number words is clearly an important contributor to mathematical competence, and educators who have used this system have exploited its simplicity and transparency in their instruction. They have made full use of this well-designed system of number words to help students build a solid understanding of basic mathematical concepts, which in turn facilitates their later mathematics learning. To promote mathematical understanding in young children who use the English system of number words, teachers can develop instructional strategies to compensate for its irregularities. For example, its number naming. Doing so will help students overcome early difficulties in learning mathematical concepts and operations. That's all the video presentation from us. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and also subscribe. Bye-bye!